So you've been thinking about actually trying to either get back into Path of Exile, or you want to try it out for the first time. Maybe you have a friend who is like me, a crazy person, and they're telling you, hey, let's play this game together, you're going to love it. You've also heard that you need a master's degree in mathematics to understand this game. Well, today I'm going to give you some tips for a brand new beginner on trying to understand Path of Exile and possibly, maybe, even have some fun. So a few of you will think to yourselves, you know what? I want to go end game. It's been 20 years since I played Diablo 2. I did endless bail runs during that. I can handle this game. Let me find a fantastic end game build, and I'm going to go from there, and I'm going to do all the end game uber bosses, and I'm going to be top ranked. It's going to be awesome. Well, no, that's not how this works. You see, the problem with that is that this game came out in 2013. You've got about 9 years of content to catch up on. On top of that, trying to use an endgame build that has been done by someone who is incredibly intelligent, has played this game since beta, and understands the ins and outs, and then trying to use that either in your first playthrough or your second playthrough or your third league even, really doesn't make a lot of sense because you're going to be missing a lot of the fundamentals that this game honestly requires you to learn. So with that, what I want you to do as your very first tip is not to look up any guides. I don't want you to try and sit there and force yourself into a guide that's going to push you in either a direction you don't want to play, a build you're not going to enjoy, or the gear and skills that you have will not match what is actually dropping, especially if you don't know how to use the trade economy. And that's really the big reason, right? A lot of people who are very seasoned will do specific trades, start leagues, know crafting. They know all these ins and outs and tricks that you don't know yet, or you basically forgot, and then are going to be leagues ahead of you, no pun intended, in that build specifically. So like I said, trying to get an end game guide is really not going to be your best bet. Your best bet, however, is going to go through and actually just having fun with the game. So we've gone ahead and said, okay, Alex, I'm going to take your advice. I'm not going to dive into Reddit. I'm not going to dig through forums. I'm not going to go to PoE builds and try to find a build that's going to get me to end game and the maps and Uber Pinnacle and all that stuff. I'm just going to play the game like normal. Great. We are now in the character select screen. And of course, here is my character for the Kalandra League, which ends in a few days. And that is Bata Susia. I am mapping with her right now. The thing is, though, when you begin your actual journey in the Path of Exile, you have a few options. You have the standard league, which is the regular game, which all the other league's content is rolled into the standard league. You have the current league, which begins around every 3 months. And you can go ahead and play that league on a league start if you want to. And then you have hardcore, right? Now, hardcore means one life. That's it. I would avoid, honestly, the current league if you're not doing it day one, and also hardcore in the beginning. You're going to do just standard, right? Let's get an idea for the game and figure out what we're going to do then. You then can choose in the standard league if you want to do hardcore in that or solo self-found. Solo self-found basically disables any sort of trading, right? So you can't trade between other players. It's basically whatever you find by yourself, hey, that's what you got. Some people like it, some people don't. I stay in the trade league, but I never trade, so who knows? But once you've gone ahead and picked your league, click OK, and you've got yourself a set of classes you can choose from. You'll pick your class, you'll go from there, and then you start the game. So here we are with my character, and I am in the endgame area. Now, what I want to show you guys is something that a lot of people really do overlook when they first start playing Path of Exile. There is a really weird onboarding process. It does some things really well, but it does other things not so good. And I think the first big thing everyone truly does miss is this little icon right here on the bottom right-hand side, the Open Help panel. This is incredibly important because if you have any sort of question about what is going on in the game, you have a veritable encyclopedia of everything that's going on inside of Path of Exile, whether it's skill gems, the basics, requirements and restrictions, the passive skill tree, rarity tiers, flasks, your stash, waypoints, alignments, even leagues that are rolled into the standard league or the current league mechanic are all here as well for things like Delve, Incursions, and it explains everything to you here in great detail, mind you. So if you ever run into a mechanic that you don't understand or you're trying to figure something out in terms of skills, gems, gearing, whatever question you might have, it's here. Definitely want to take a look at it. You can also click glossary and then you can search for what you want to look for and go from there. So this little icon is always overlooked, but it is incredibly important because it's a good resource if you have any questions and you're kind of lost on what something is or what's going on. You can look it up there and say, oh, now I have an idea. So let's go to this really weird stat from Chris Wilson that he stated himself. It turns out that 50% of players who begin playing Path of Exile quit before the end of Act 1. So before someone is even level 10, they've actually quit the game completely. Sometimes people just play the first league mechanic in that first set of areas, decide if they don't want to do the league or if they do want to do it, and they'll quit there. Some people open up the skill tree, which we'll go into next, and then just quit there because that's one of the first things you get introduced to. Some people just get overwhelmed and then they quit. So one thing I really want to bring up for you guys is if you do decide to play Path of Exile, my recommendation, right, is to actually complete part one and then decide what you want to do from there. Now you're probably thinking to yourself, Alex, why should I only complete the first five acts if there are 10 acts in this game plus endgame? Isn't the endgame what I want to do? Yes. However, when you go ahead and you get to the part two of the game, acts 6 through 10, you basically just repeat everything from the first five acts. You go to the same locations, all of the missions do change and the quests change. You sort of like do it all over again. And that's sort of like the slog people have to go through when playing this. That's when you're really going to decide, hey, am I going to stick with this for real? And am I going to actually go into mapping, into endgame, do all that wacky stuff, and have all that endgame content that I want to play? Because the part two of this game can be a slog if you're really not looking forward to it. They are saying they're going to fix a lot of that sort of like story beat stuff for Path of Exile 2. But just be aware, right? My recommendation is beat the first five acts if you're having a good time, if you're enjoying what the game has to offer, if you're getting more into it, then hey, beat the next five acts, get into mapping, and then you're really gonna start digging into stuff, okay? So give the game at least the first five acts before you decide, hey, I wanna take this to a really hardcore sort of area. So now comes the fun part of Path of Exile. This is where people get really freaked out about the game specifically, and it's the skill tree. Now, if you've never seen this skill tree before, I suggest you take some Tylenol before we go ahead and open it up. So I'll just give you a quick second there. Okay, this is the skill tree for Path of Exile. It is massive. If you ever played FF10, it's very similar to that. I guess you could say that in its appearance. So every class is actually on this actual tree and you can move into any direction that you want. So you have complete freedom of what you want to build. My problem with Path of Exile is that it gives you the entire tree at the very beginning and it doesn't give you small sets of sections of the tree. It just throws it all at you once. On top of that, there are skill trees within the skill tree and that's here as well. So when you start doing that kind of thing, you can do your ascendancy classes and then just start doing more things in another skill tree inside of that tree. I hope the Tylenol is kicking in. This is complex. It's not confusing. And I think that's what I really want to just bring out to you guys if you guys are trying to do Path of Exile. My suggestion is this. The class that you pick and the stat that you focus on, that's what you want to do. My Ranger class is High Dexterity. I clearly do not want to pick any sort of like mana or strength nodes, unless I'm trying to do something in that class. When I'm first playing though, my suggestion is think about what you want your class to do and then go from there. Now, what I wanted to do for my Ranger was I wanted her to just unload as many arrows as quickly as possible, as fast as possible, and flood the screen with them. That was my intention. That's what I thought would be ideal. And that's sort of where I wanted to do things. So in the skill tree, there's a really great thing with the search tab. It's kind of tough to see, but it's up here on the top right-hand side. And all you can do is just type things like speed. So then it will highlight every single node that has attack speed included in it. And if you zoom out, you can see here's everything with attack speed. So now I can say, okay, what are the really interesting nodes that I can choose from? So in the beginning, I can say, okay, here's projectile damage and attack speed, attack speed, attack speed, attack speed. So with ballistics, I've got 20% increased projectile speed, increased projectile damage, 20 dexterity, right? Not too bad. You're thinking to yourself, Alex, why did you not pick those nodes? Well, because I've made a lot of mistakes, and that's okay, because we'll get into that in just a moment. But the thing is this, you want to go ahead and experiment. You want to try things out. You want to go through and say, hey, let me try this skill. Let me try that skill. Let me see how this fits with my build. Let me see how that fits. And you have the ability to make those mistakes. Pick skills and abilities that you think will work, that you think are going to be part of your build. And then if you don't like them, you can refund those skill points. As you can see, I have refund points left because there's a currency that allows you to refund passive skill tree points. So do not be afraid of going in and just trying stuff out, because you'll be able to make the currency back in order to refund those points, rebuild your tree, and then try things again. So don't worry about, like, did I pick the right skill? Am I min-maxing properly? That's not what you should be focusing on. What you should be focusing on is, am I having fun with this build? Are enemies dying quickly with this build? Now I can go ahead and I can adjust things after Act 5, and I've got a better understanding of the game, I've got better gear, I've got better skill gems, and then you can start min-maxing and doing stuff and testing and playing around and doing those kinds of things. Now, this also goes into account with, let's say, reading. Now, reading is fundamental, ladies and gentlemen. It's incredibly important, and in Path of Exile, it is so important that you read skills and you read the skill point nodes and you read the gems and you read percentages and you understand mathematics. And when I say mathematics, I don't mean algebra. I mean like fifth grade percentage mathematics, right? 10% of 100 is 10. So if you have 100 strength and it says increases your strength by 10%, you're going to be at what class? 110. That's what we're talking about here, okay? This entire game is small percentages that add into big gains. So read the skill. Here's a good example of one. Point blank, projectile attack hits deal up to 30% more damage to targets at the start of their movement, dealing less damage to targets as a projectile travels farther. Now you're thinking to yourself, why would you pick that, Alex? I'm a ranger. You're going to be away from enemies. Why would you want to pick a skill that has your attacks deal less damage the farther you are away from them? In an ARPG, you are constantly surrounded by enemies and they push up onto you. So if an enemy gets very close to you as a ranger, which you don't want to be anything close to, your damage and your attacks will deal 30% more damage because they are closer to you, giving you that buffer zone of pushing those close enemies away, reducing the possibility of you getting hit because you're killing them faster or dealing 30% more damage. That's how you want to think about these sorts of skills and this game. You want to think, hey, how is this skill? How is this node? How is this gem? How is this passive ability going to impact how I play the game? And then think about what it says word for word, and then decide if you want to pick it or not. Because even though I do less damage the farther they are away, in a lot of scenarios, enemies are going to rush you. And so you want to make sure they don't hit you first. You end them before they end you. So now that you've got somewhat of a grasp of the skill tree, well, at least you're not going to vomit profusely when it comes up the first time, let's take a look at skill gems. Now, this is incredibly important because there are no skills in this game. There are gems that contain skills, and then there are gems that support those specific skills. Now, GGG has done a lot of great things, giving you some quality of life features, but you can also try to figure things out on your own. Ice Shot is a projectile AoE cold bow attack. It does cold damage by firing an arrow that converts some physical damage to cold on its target and converts all physical damage to cold in a cone behind that target. So when I do Ice Shot on its own, That's what it does. Nothing more, nothing less. So that seems pretty cool, right? Well, what if we were to, let's say, increase it a little bit, shall we? As you can see, my unique bow has 5 sockets, and these 5 sockets are linked. And what I mean by linked is really simple. There is a little connector between each socket. The goal for me is to try and have 6 sockets all linked. Now, why do I want that? Because there are attack skills and support skills that support that main attack skill. Very cool, right? So I've added ice bite support, so I can go ahead and support my ice shot by having a 15% more chance to freeze on top of what's already there. I can have a 67% chance to gain a frenzy charge, which increases my attack speed. I can have a 56 to 85 added cold damage. My supported skills have 13 and 19 added cold damage per frenzy charge. So if I want to stack frenzy charges, which of course I do in my build, which increase my attack speed, then my ice shot now does all of that. But there's more. I can stack another gem if it's linked as a support gem and add extra cold damage. I can add additional hypothermia support if I want to do that to freeze enemies. And then the big daddy of them all, I can then chain that arrow, meaning that when it hits an enemy, it will fork and then 2 more times hit 2 more enemies behind them on top of all of the other support skills that are done with Ice Shot, on top of everything that Ice Shot does. So when I say things like experiment, read, mess around, look at what's happening, that's what you want to focus on, because you can really create something incredibly special out of really basic items just because you have a good set of support gems and a good set of links on your sockets and have everything pulled together. You want to read the skill, you want to think about it, you want to read it again, and then experiment and make mistakes. Because when you make mistakes, you can erase them. And here's what I mean by erasing those mistakes. Currency is very different in Path of Exile. Currency is not just gold, it's actual items. And the first set of currency you're going to find is called Scrolls of Wisdom and Portal Scrolls. You're going to find a lot of these items when you first start playing. As you progress later on, you're going to see other things too, like Orbs of Alteration, Orbs of Augmentation, and also Orbs of Transmutation very early on in the game. Now, these items also have specific costs. So if you want to think about it, it costs you 3 Scrolls of Wisdom, which helps you identify items, to get 1 Portal Scroll. But then you can go ahead and use 7 Portal Scrolls to buy an Orb of Transmutation. You can then use 4 Orbs of Transmutation to get an Orb of Augmentation. You can then use that Orb of Augmentation to go ahead and purchase other currencies like the Orb of Alteration. And then you can use those specific currencies as they continue to stack upon each other into different ways of actually getting the currency that you want. And what I mean by that is very simple. So I wanted my bow to have 6 sockets. It only has 5. Well, I can buy a jeweler's orb, which gives me the chance to reforge the number of sockets on an item. Now that is RNG. It's going to be random with the amount of sockets that I get. So I have to get a lot of these. I can then go ahead and get an orb of fusing, which costs 4 jeweler's orbs, to go ahead and say, let's link all these sockets together. Now that, of course, is also RNG. Now let's talk about the Orb of Regret. I can get 2 orbs of scouring, which costs 4 orbs of chance, and I can use these orbs of regret to refund passive skill points in my skill tree. So again, even if you make a mistake, you want to min-max, you figured things out, you want to test, you can just go ahead and use your currency in order to figure out what do I need, how do I get what I need, and then just play the game while having fun, whether it's farming, experimenting, testing, or trying to make your ideal weapon with your ideal set of support gems because you got a good item. That's the fun of Path of Exile. That is the part where things are complex, and they get more complex as well. Now, when I say more complex, I wasn't kidding. The thing is, though, Path of Exile does a really bad job of drip-feeding you these complexities, and hopefully this helps you out. So you see, you have these amounts of currencies that you can get. You also have your skill gems, which you can get. You have essences, which also modify specific items. You have flasks, which of course you don't buy potions. You actually just have these flasks that recharge during specific sort of things that are met while you're playing the game by either beating enemies or things like that. You have uniques, which of course my bow and my quiver are uniques as well. Divination cards, if you want to do that too. There's mapping, which is endgame content. There's fragments, if you want to do that, for Breach, Scarab, and Eldritch, if you want to do that. There's Delve, there's Metamorph, there's Blight, Delirium, there's Lake of Calandra. There's all kinds of things. And you know what? You can ignore all of it. You can absolutely ignore every single bit of it. As you are beginning to play Path of Exile, you can literally ignore every single league mechanic that is instilled into the standard league or even the current league and just play the game normally. You don't have to min-max every single thing. You don't have to be an expert in every single mechanic because this game offers you the ability to then tweak, adjust, and modify and just explore those different game mechanics that are applied. So just because it's there doesn't mean you have to spend all of your time doing that thing. Let's go ahead and just play this and have fun and gain an understanding so we can build upon what we have later on and then dive deep into it. Now, here's my second to last bit of advice. You need an item filter. PoE loves to dump huge amounts of loot on top of you while you're playing the game. A lot of it you can use, a lot of it you're not gonna use, a lot of it just doesn't make a lot of sense, and you don't know what's good or what's bad. An item filter is absolutely ideal. Now, I of course use Filter Blade, and I will put a link to that in the description down below. There are tons of videos that help you understand how to use Filter Blade in a much more in-depth way, so you can check those out on your own time and definitely try to use that specifically. Now, what I do personally is either during every league start, I try to keep things semi-strict. And I don't really mess with a lot of things because I'm not really looking for anything specific until I start going deeper into end game. Then you can make a lot of changes in what you want to see, how you want to see it, the kinds of items you want to see. So I keep it pretty simple. All I do is never sync SC because it's updated every 4 hours. I keep it on normal, and then I just go ahead, save and export it, and then I plug it into PoE, and it works just fine. If you want to go deeper into it and you want to have more customization, it gets very granular, so you definitely can do that. And of course, this is highly, highly recommended that you do. So what do you guys think of my tips for Path of Exile? Let me know in the comment section down below. I know you're probably thinking like, what was the best build for Uber Shaper, Alex? Where's your 1.5 million DPS, my boy? That's not what this is going to be about. But if anything that I talked about today gave you an inkling of wanting to try Path of Exile or even check it out whatsoever, and then just enjoy a game that is absolutely free and just costs you nothing to play except maybe your sanity and some mathematics, then I did my job and it worked out well. Now, of course, if you want to see more of this content, subscribe. And if you want to join my Discord, you can do that by becoming a YouTube member, a Patreon sub, or a Twitch sub. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you have a great one, and I'll see you next time.